Faut peut-être une autre méthode. Répète après moi.
If only I was a Disney character, I wouldn't even have to work anymore.
Are you serious? Dragons are bad guys in Disney movies! Hello everyone! Welcome to this new year 2021! I hope you're all doing great, and today I will tell you about how I ended up discovering the furry fandom and how I eventually became one myself. It all started about 10 years ago. I was in middle school and I had just discovered Sonic the Hedgehog. It didn't take long before I turned into a huge fan. I clearly remember that my friends and family were annoyed because it was the only thing I ever talked about. I even started to make comics. I would have loved to show them to you, but I lost all of them, unfortunately. What an idiot! Later, my obsession for Sonic started to fade, and something else was taking all the space in my heart. Dragons. I honestly don't remember how I got into dragons, but it was the same thing, I was obsessed. Instead of drawing Sonic characters, I was learning how to draw dragons, and I even started making stories too. Still in 2010, I read a book called Liu and the Old Dragon. It's not well known, it's only in French, and it's not even edited anymore, but I loved that book. And later, I read another novel called Dragon Age of Fire. It is the first volume of a series written by E.E. Knight. It makes you follow the story of a dragon from birth to adulthood. It's captivating, but I never read the other books because I was too attached to the first one's characters. The next year, in 2011, I discovered the website that changed everything for me. No, it's not Fur Affinity. I discovered that one much later. Most of you have never heard of it. It's called Herpy Reptiles Lover Community. It doesn't exist anymore now, it's been taken down years ago. It contained a picture gallery and a forum, which is what I'm going to talk about. On the forum, people had dragon characters and considered each other as such. That was the concept of persona, but there was no name for it. My character back then was called Shinru. It was a pink dragon, and here is a picture of it. Just think about it, I was considered as a dragon and that felt amazing. I had never heard about something like that before. That was totally new and I thought this was a thing only on this one website. I didn't even know about the furry fandom, I had no idea it was a worldwide thing. Of course, later I found Fur Affinity and started making some friends. I also wanted to create my own persona, so I made this pink dragon. It was still called Shinru back then, but later I renamed it Kawaku. Now, let's jump in time and go to 2015. I was in college and I had just discovered that there were furries in my own country too, in France. I started talking with lots of French furries and one of them told me about a furry event that happened once every year called Furry Underground Dance, or FUD. I went there on May of 2016 and it changed my life. Again. I saw fursuits for the first time and someone there even let me wear one and I had never felt like this before. It really was a magical weekend for me, and I forgot to mention, this was also the first time I met other furries. From that moment on, I'll admit, things went rather fast. I got obsessed with getting a fursuit, but I didn't have much money, so I rushed to a builder with low prices and commissioned. And I finally got my first suit in October of 2016, right before my first convention, Fursuit Blacklight. Now it's called Furry Blacklight, but that's how it was called back then. I've had amazing memories with this fursuit. It's crazy when I think that I've been wearing it for almost 4 years. And now I have this new fursuit that I love even more, made by my friend Omegapos. I got it in June of 2020, and in June of 2020, all the cons and furmeets were cancelled. At least it's going to last longer, I guess. There are conventions in VRChat though, because when the lockdown happened, a lot of people rushed to VR, and right now the furry fandom is also developing there. In the end, the furry fandom has truly changed my life completely, and I wonder what I would be doing right now if I had never discovered it. I would probably have discovered it later in different conditions, and maybe I would have become a different person if I had. There is so many ways you can discover this fandom. Like when I started playing VRChat, I met a lot of people who discovered the furry fandom from the game and from the person they met there. And that was the story of how I became a furry. I hope you found it entertaining, and if you want to share how you found the fandom, write it in the comment sections and let's all share our stories, no matter if you found the fandom months ago or 20 years ago. Thank you for watching my video. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! Let's be honest, guys. Every single one of you discovered the furry fandom with furry porn.